Sometimes rocks can come loose from pervious concrete. This is known as raveling. Though unsightly, raveling is a superficial problem, not affecting the entire depth of the pavement, only the topmost layer. It's usually most prevalent along the edges and joints. If raveling does occur, it begins to show up within a few weeks of placement and then winds down, being mostly done after about 4 months. It can be common with pervious concrete, but extreme raveling can always be avoided if you understand why it happens. Evaporation is the main reason. There are many factors that contribute to evaporation and make pervious concrete particularly vulnerable to the effects of it. Pervious concrete has voids that allow water to pass through it. These voids give the material a large surface area. This means the topmost layer of the freshly placed pavement has a lot of contact with the air. The more contact with the air, the more evaporation occurs. For this reason, pervious concrete differs significantly from ordinary concrete and has its own unique timing and placing considerations. With ordinary concrete, excess water known as bleed water slowly rises to the top after placement, replacing the water on the surface that is lost to evaporation. Pervious concrete, on the other hand, doesn't have any excess water to give. The window to get just the right amount of water in the mix is extremely narrow. Pervious concrete basically consists of a thin layer of cement paste coating each piece of aggregate. Since the cement paste is so thin, water that evaporates does not get replaced. If this cement coating dries past a certain point before it has a chance to set, the bond between the aggregate particles will be compromised. Shortly after placing, the bond can fail and rock will come loose. In this way, too much evaporation can lead to raveling. The rate of evaporation is affected by the surface area, wind, humidity, and most of all, temperature. Pavement in full sun can have a surface temperature well above ambient. This can lead to an alarming rate of evaporation. Even on a fairly cool day, surfaces can reach temperatures well into the hundreds, above 50 Celsius. This can be disastrous for a pervious concrete installation. It doesn't take much to exceed the critical point. If just 5% of the mix water has evaporated from the surface of the pervious concrete, it will become noticeably stiffer and may begin to tear as you're working it. At this point, the pervious concrete surface begins to become unworkable or unfinishable. It becomes harder to blend and apply the final finish. An unworkable consistency is a sign that too much evaporation has occurred. If you work past this point and apply the final finish anyway, there will likely be raveling of the surface later on. Pervious concrete made with small aggregate not only has a larger surface area, but it also has a thinner coating of cement paste around each grain. The thinner the paste, the more susceptible it is to the effects of evaporation. A 3/8 aggregate can become unfinishable within 5 minutes when left in full, midday sun, but a small aggregate, less than 1/8 inch, can become unfinishable in as little as 2 minutes of sun exposure. But despite the shorter working time, we still prefer fine aggregate pervious concrete for aesthetic reasons. Not only is the surface smoother, but if raveling does occur, it's less noticeable. To combat raveling, you must plan to put environmental conditions to your advantage. Having the pervious concrete in full shade, rather than full sun, can easily lengthen the working time by a factor of 5 or more. There are evaporation-reducing and offsetting admixtures for pervious concrete, but so far none come close to having this level of impact on working time. Attention to the following 4 points will provide the greatest insurance against raveling. Make sure your pervious concrete is optimally hydrated and kept cool. Check out our video, How to Make Pervious Concrete, for more info on this. Carefully consider the weather during your installation. Install the concrete quickly and steadily, compacting in a timely manner. And make sure the concrete is properly cured. Keep your pervious concrete cool before and during mixing. It will have a longer working time. If your mix is hot, a lot of water will evaporate before you even get a chance to place it on the ground. If your concrete has to travel far between the mixing site and the installation, you may want to add additional water to account for this. If you're mixing on site, keep your mixer in the shade. If you need to leave the mixer going for a long time, periodically add more water to prevent the mix from drying out too much. If getting your pervious concrete from a batch or ready mix plant, don't expect the delivery of a perfect mix. You need to know what to look for with every load and be able to adjust accordingly. Though, start early to take full advantage of the morning weather and have everything prepared a day or two in advance. This includes having the base properly compacted and soaked with water, joints marked, and all your tools and materials on hand. If you anticipate needing to pour in less than ideal conditions or you have a small crew, you can extend the working time of your pervious concrete by setting up shade canopies or shade fabric to keep the pervious concrete out of the hot sun. Misting fans can be used to humidify the installation area. Just be careful. If water from the misters condenses on overhanging shrubs or a shade canopy and drips onto the concrete, it can wash away paste and cause raveling. This can also happen if the pervious concrete gets rained on before it is covered in plastic. If this happens, you may have time to cover the spot with fresh material and refinish it, but if the concrete has already begun to set, it's best to leave it be. We like to use high-pressure misting systems, so the water droplets are very small. We found that non-pressurized misters put out drops of water that are too big. Large droplets of water can fall and wash away the paste. Use spray bottles to mist specific areas that are drying out. As the morning gets a little warmer and drier, we spray the pervious concrete on the ground before blending it with the next batch. If a section of pervious concrete has dried out before getting a chance to finish it, mist it to replenish some of the water and blend in fresh material to make it more workable. The faster the pervious concrete is placed and finished, the better. The material is easier to work with when it's fresh, so you can work faster. If you work faster, you will always be working while the pervious concrete is fresh, so it will take less time to apply the final finish. For this reason, the pour becomes almost exponentially faster if there are more workers, provided they can all work in the confines of the space. Placing pervious concrete continuously, finishing as you go, will help ensure a strong surface free of raveling. If the crew is big or experienced enough, it can be best to pour the entire width of the pavement at once, as we did for this driveway. Extra wide areas are more manageable if poured in separate sections, divided by a joint, which can be created by placing a temporary form between them. When coming back to fill in sections, be very careful not to disturb the edge of the existing pervious concrete. Pervious concrete that is disturbed after it has begun to set is very likely to ravel. Raveling appears most commonly along edges and joints, so these areas require extra attention. We prefer to make joints by using wedges that will compact the pervious concrete, not cut it. When it first goes down, step on the pervious concrete along the edges and forms, as these areas are difficult to compact later on. Then add more material over what you compacted and finish with an edger, leaving a compacted, rounded edge. Place joints and edges as soon as possible. Waiting too long to install a joint can dislodge aggregate that was already set in place, leading to raveling. Timing is key with all concrete placement. Pervious concrete, with its own unique timing, can be summarized as place as fast as possible. With pervious concrete, there really isn't a way to place it too fast. Perhaps the only caveat being if the mix is too wet to begin with, finishing early can make it sealed up. With our very fine mixes, sealing up is rarely a problem, and in general, we find it much easier to get a more consistent texture. We like to finish our fine mixes first by using a magnesium or aluminum float to level and blend areas, and then follow with a steel trowel. However, we don't typically recommend steel trowels for pervious concrete made with coarser aggregates. Because of their thicker paste, they can easily seal up when finished with a steel trowel or Fresno. Sealing up can be minimized by using a wood or resin float for the initial smoothing and blending, and then a magnesium or aluminum float for the final finishing. If a section appears sealed up, dig it out right away and fill with fresh material. On large installations of pervious concrete, rotating pizza pan type finishers seem to be able to provide just the right touch that can minimize the occurrence of sealed up areas and provide a nice overall finish. The degree and timing of the compaction of the fresh pervious concrete can make a big impact on raveling. In general, the sooner the compaction is applied, the less force is needed. For very fine aggregates, we find the compaction provided by the steel trowel is adequate. However, steel Fresnos with 20 pounds or so of weight can also be used. Coarser mixes require more compaction than can be done by hand. In large applications, spin screeds are often used. followed by a heavy cross roller. If the cross roller is used, it could be better to run it over the plastic to minimize the amount of aggregate that sticks to it. When doing this, however, you should periodically check under the plastic to ensure the pavement isn't being overly compacted and sealed up. In some situations, a magnesium bowl float with at least 20 pounds of weight may be adequate. For other applications, equipment like this trail rider can place and compact pervious concrete at the same time, making for even faster installations. We've been discussing reducing evaporation and causes of raveling during the installation process, but equally important is the curing process. The water in the concrete that we've been working so hard to maintain must now be locked in to ensure the pervious concrete can properly hydrate and cure over the following days. To do this, immediately cover each section with plastic as it is completed. Create a tight seal by overlapping all the edges and use plenty of boards and other heavy objects to weigh the plastic down so it doesn't blow away later. Wait at least 4 days before removing the plastic. Many recommend 7 days or more. Most instances of raveling in pervious concrete can be avoided by paying attention to evaporation. However, there are a couple other potential causes worth addressing as well. We mentioned earlier that overhead water can lead to raveling, but a similar thing can happen if the mix is just too wet to begin with. The paste can drain off the surface of the aggregate. If this should occur, it's best to mix the overly wet material with fresh, drier material, then respread. Pervious concrete can be a great solution in colder climates. However, if de-icing salts are used before the pavement has properly cured, or if it wasn't designed to withstand them, this could also lead to raveling. If you happened to cross this video too late and there is raveling in your pervious concrete, we have outlined several solutions on our website, perviousproducts.com.